What's up, Bulldogs?
Welcome back to another episode of PNN.
Coming up, you'll be seeing the story behind a beloved animal shelter here in Irvine, catching up with an alumni on his rise to stardom and learning more about the opportunities Portola has to offer.
But before we get started, let's get into some announcements.
Portola is this Friday, so make sure to come and support your fellow musicians.
Portola Choirs will be holding a Vocal Pops concert on May 26th. We can't wait to see our talented Bulldogs perform.
There are so many ways to give back to our community, and the Irvine Animal Care Center is an especially adorable option for those looking for an irreplaceable companion.
They always say dogs are a man's best friend. That is no different for the pets here at the Irvine Animal Care Center.
Animals all around Irvine are rescued and rehabilitated right here at the Care Center, especially by one person passionate about their work.
I'm Paige Kim, and I'm the Behavior and Enrichment Coordinator. I've been working at the Irvine Animal Care Center since 2005.
Animals have always been a big part of Paige's life.
I'm originally from Texas. My parents weren't great pet owners, very kind of old-fashioned. Dogs were in the backyard, cats were outside.
As Paige grew up, she realized that the bond she shared with her animals had developed into a passion.
I wasn't brave enough, I think, might be the best word, to really fulfill that as a career until, when I was in college and, you know, completely pivoted on accident almost.
As working with puppies and kittens may seem fun, there are some struggles of caring for these animals in need.
The ones I remember the most were really, really sad, but we've had a couple, so just imagine an apartment patio, not big, right? And they never took the dog off of the patio, they never let the dog in, so there was just poop everywhere, and the dog was just living in, you know, a layer of poop and filth, and they were throwing food and water out for it, and so it was like, you know, come on, man.
Throughout Paige's experience, she has always empathized with the pets she's received and stood up for their well-being.
I think it's very easy to be very judgmental about how people own their pets, but that's not gonna change anything. So if you can help somebody understand, like, maybe instead of doing X, let's do Y, and these are small changes that'll overall improve the animal's welfare and help them understand why we need to fulfill, you know, whatever need from the animal, that's really where you make that difference.
But with hard work and perseverance, Paige is able to support these animals and bring them to a state of adoptability.
We had a dog here named Captain Jack who was here for over a year, and he came in and he was very difficult, and we worked with him, we helped him adjust and deal with the center, and he finally got adopted by a really wonderful family who understood him and all of his quirks, and he's doing great. You have to approach that with empathy and understanding. I mean, Irvine's so multicultural. There's also lots of cultural differences to owning pets, and you really have to be intelligent about that and understand and help people relate to that.
With Paige's skill and kindness, she has created homes for hundreds of animals here in Irvine.
If you're thinking of adding a new furry friend to your family, make sure you consider rescuing locally at the Irvine Animal Care Center and providing a home for a pet in need. This is Andrea Rees reporting for PNN.
Even the toughest people are softened by the affection of an animal. Speaking of strong-willed people, our resilience athletes practice every day on our campus. They demonstrate Portola's core values both on and off the playing field. Take it away, sports.
Step it up, always take the risk. Living life, go hard and don't quit.
Go hard.
Drip, splash, like the ice on the wrist. That's a call I can't miss. Set my goals like a goal, hit the switch. Work, 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 check it off the checklist. In a position to win, in a position to go. In a position to win, in a position to go. In a position to win, in a position to go. In a position to win, in a position to go.
What's up, everyone? It's Ennis, and welcome back to another segment of PNN Sports. Sadly, our spring season is coming to a close, but here are some new sports updates. First off, baseball conquered University and Beckman with a score of 5-3. Softball destroyed University with a score of 22-8. Next, boys golf demolished Laguna Hills with a score of 161-237 and beat Beckman with a score of 195-206. Congratulations to track and field for finishing in first place in the Pacific Coast League for both girls and boys varsity. For swim, the girls team got second place in the PCL championships with a score of 503.5, and the boys team placed second as well with a score of 463 points. Next, boys tennis overpowered Laguna Hills with a score of 16-2. Girls lacrosse clinched first in PCL with wins over Northwood with a score of 12-8 and Laguna Hills with a score of 20-1. Last but not least, boys lacrosse defeated El Medina with a score of 6-5 and Laguna Hills with a score of 15-10. Well, that's it for my final sports updates of the year. Before I go, I wanted to wish good luck to all of our senior Bulldog athletes who will be competing in a sport in college. And most importantly, thank you all for listening. And now I'll pass it back to Seraphina and Andrea.
In this next feature, one of our very own alumni appears on screen as they explore another exhilarating aspect of the entertainment industry.
Celebrities, stars, and fame are forms of art that differ from paintings. In the realm of stardom, idols hold significant popularity. Interestingly, a Portola alumni is one step closer to achieving the status than most.
My name is Lucas, and my Chinese name is Yan Haojun, and I'm 21 years old. 我对 C-pop 或 K-pop 这东西吧，从 16岁才开始了解，然后16岁被星探发掘以后，去了韩国那边，然后先小试了一个月，然后发现这个行业比我想象的要有意思。As
a young boy shaped by the influence of various stars, Lucas held a special connection with one particular idol.
因为我老去我爸工作室嘛。 然后就看我爸那儿画画，就当时觉得挺厉害的。小时候我跟我小学同学就是说啊，我爸可以在网上搜到，因为我也不知道就别人的父亲就是在网上搜不到的，因为我觉得所有的父亲应该是在网上都能搜到的，我就跟他们说了一嘴。Unbeknownst
to him, his father was an idol who was admired by many.
我是杨少斌，是。
Mr. Yang is a renowned artist who also underwent various struggles and hardships during his artistic journey to discover his signature style, which evolved from cynical realism to his own self-developed form of realism, the red violets.
红色暴力的时候呢，那个时期，其实我正好在圆明园的时候，其实那个时候因为大家都很穷嘛，就对未来。 都比较迷茫和焦虑，那个时候，然后，就在自身自己的身上发生了一些事情，然后就慢慢的把这个情绪转化成要表达的一个出口。Mr.
Yang's work primarily delves into serious topics such as the political climate and social movements, which appears to be a far cry from his son's work as a C-pop artist. Due to these differences, Mr. Yang initially had difficulty comprehending his son's passions.
我是差不多15岁吧，跟他说我想做练习生，然后我爸他就一惊嘛。我们对这个也不太了解，我说怎么去可以当练习生啊？后来就我跟他妈妈说，他说这个没办法，他也不认识人。
But with the power of a little chance and Portola High School,
我有一次在学校，然后跟我朋友在学校门口，然后被一星探发现了。而那时候我真不想把这名片给妈妈，我以为这是骗子，你知道吗？Determined
to follow his passion, Lucas participated in a reality training show called Youth With You. Through this rigorous process, he underwent a realization about the true meaning of art to him.
对我来说，艺术的目的，那就是可能是表达我个人的一种情绪的东西，对这个，对我自己生活的一种看法。Throughout
his journey, Lucas experienced the harsh realities of striving for stardom and realized that his own artistic values aligned with his father's.
这个，我觉得这个影视行业的挑战，我觉得。 绘画呀，什么就挑战，我觉得都差不多，我觉得都很难，啊，我觉得有挑战来说，还是比较幸运的话有挑战。Whether
they are idols or artists, well known or not, the father and son will forever shine like the brightest stars in the sky. Together.
There are endless opportunities here at Portola. We have such a wide range of artists, each with their own unique talent.
As students, we often take for granted the opportunities we're given, but these students don't share that privilege. The Unified Program here at Portola serves the purpose of integrating general education programs and special education programs, creating one united learning experience. And these two students were touched by the programs and thrive in them.
My name is Alec Curtis, and I am a junior.
My name is Lucas. I am a junior at Portola High School.
Why do you love
the Unified Art and PE program?
Because it is fun.
I look into ceramics because I make stuff and play with clay. I say hi to people and because it's a quiet place and that makes me happy.
And this parent has firsthand experience of seeing her child blossom through it.
Hi, I'm Mother Heather Nguyen. My son goes to Portola High School and attends Miss Melody's class. So the Unified Sports Program, when it was first introduced, I thought it was a great opportunity for kids, you know, to be able to engage with their peers from a parent perspective, that this is such an inclusive environment and that not so much making my son feel special, but making him quote unquote normal, right? That he's part of the school, he's part of this, you know, community that you guys have going on here.
I get excited when I do art. I have been drawing since I was a kid.
It makes me feel happy because I like to do art. I like to be able to do something that I got while I'm at school. I also like to exercise.
Do you have a moment when you felt a sense of belonging and happiness in the program?
I felt happy because I got an award at the art show for my Super Mario ceramic spoon holder. I also felt like I belonged at the pep rally when I scored 3-pointers and everyone cheered for me. That was awesome. I would like to get a job where I can do art. Maybe I'll take art classes in the community after high school.
I want to keep drawing pictures, playing sports with friends and B8 Michigan, who plays the drums fast.
The impact this program has had on these wonderful students is unmatched.
To have that social experience, to have that, you know, that peer group, you know, experience, you know, it just builds up a little, I think, if anything, it builds up the confidence, right? And I hope that this program will bring awareness, not just to, you know, the parents or the kids in these kind of programs, but also to our general, you know, community too.
Unified programs at Portola are a step towards unity, and we need your help as students to help them grow.
Well, that wraps up this week's episode. Thank you so much for watching.
We'll see you next time for our season 6 finale of PNN.
That's right.